will become the leading cause of disability in the under 45 population by the year 2020. As a hospital executive officer, coach for 20 years, and parent of 5 high school and college athletes, it's a wonder I have any brain cells left myself, turned clinician scientist who stood shoulder to shoulder with Dr. Ann McKee one afternoon as she autopsied the brains of 2 professional players, I can tell you firsthand, this is very real. I've seen it with my eyes. And we had better start shifting from making sports safer for players to making players in their brain safer for sports. So do we really need another advocacy and education group, star-studded as it is? The answer is actually no, we don't. But we do need a great one. We need a great one. We need Jeremy Roenick and we need Jim McMahon to be great one more time. Oh. Our just published book is on your tables. It takes a first step. It's primarily written for high school and college students, their parents and coaches. It's fast track innovation though applies to pro players and providers as well, and it does make players and their brains safer for sports. It's this new science of neuroepigenetics. Believe it or not, we have figured out how to improve the functioning, preservation, and growth of brain cells tied back to turning on genes that are good and turning off genes that are bad. And the book tries to explain that in understandable terms to players because they're the ones that really need us now. The most exciting, though, and smartest thing the book does is it activates players, and it does so aligned with the Marine and Army Rangers' mantra to never leave a head hurt buddy in danger or behind. And that's the biggest thing that we can do right up front. In closing, let me make one thing 100% clear. We are very much behind pro sports and youth sports.
Yes.
I never would have got through parenting if it wasn't for sports. I mean, really, it's so much a part of our culture. And you know what? In a cohort of 8-year-olds, the best research ever done, the difference between fit and unfit kids is a 12% larger brain. And that same research group just came out 3 weeks ago and discovered not only is the gray matter of these kids larger, but white matter is more fibrous and more, you know, communication-wise, the best that could possibly be between brain cells. And that's why their scores academically are so high. So we need sports on the other side of this. Beyond our brain-saving and life-saving book, we meet this Friday with the leading innovators in the world at Harvard Business School. We're very excited about that. They somehow heard about us. And what we're going to do is target physician ACOs between 200 to 500 MDs at a time to help train them on what this concussion thing is all about and the fact that there actually is a neuroepigenetic solution. Because there's more than one way to skin a cat, and we're going to get to these docs one way or the other. We know they want to do the right thing. Our next book, by the way, is going to be about every possible way to prevent, mitigate, and possibly reverse head injuries, long-term consequences of CTE and Alzheimer's. A lot of people say that can't happen. I bet I'm the only one besides my wife in this room who knows. 2 days ago, it was just discovered for the first time in 9 out of 10 Alzheimer's subjects that the memory loss these guys suffer can be reversed. That's amazing. So CTE, here we come. We're going to get that heading in the right direction, so you bet. I know Jim can speak to the importance of this. I'm just going to tell you honestly right up front. My wife and I can look forward to the fact that it's the best hedge that our fourth child has to recover from his brain concussions. He's 10 years out, had his first concussion at 14, and he's only now beginning to come back. So we have a personal stake in this matter. You should know about that. But Jim and Jeremy and PAC, the world needs you. Again, it needs you to be great one more time. And you guys are good at that, right?
Yeah. Yeah.
You guys are good at that. On behalf of all the lives I am privileged to represent here tonight, especially on behalf of our co-author, Dr. Alan Gashier, who's put 30 years into this. He's the guy that came up with Heads Up, Don't Duck back in the 90s for USA Hockey. When he heard we were going to get to speak tonight, he had tears in his eyes. He's still doing 14 to 16 hour days sometimes at St. Elizabeth's Hospital at 76 years old. He couldn't be more dedicated. Thank you for the applause for him. He is the best. Again, thank you, Jim McMahon and Jeremy Roenick. You guys are really doing, you have no idea, maybe you do, how important this is. And, you know, Tom, we look forward to working with you guys. If we can pull this off, we are committing to donate $1.5 million to you guys through the proceeds. Thank you very much. I know I went on too long. Don't worry, everybody. Just one cat.
Jeremy Roenick says I'm way out in front of my skis.